leg wide open has Ochoa. Ramon Ochoa down to the 13-yard line. He got in behind Dozier on the play.
One coming from 27 yards out. And Kaden, one of 24 seniors, playing his final home game. A man who was downright emotional before the game.
Gets it through. When we come back, Assad Abdul-Khalik will lead Minnesota onto the field on offense. We'll be back.
Dozier Ingram. Just got that one inside the right upright from 33 yards out. And we are knotted at three apiece. This time they convert on the field goal, and Iowa will have the ball when we come back to Kinnick Stadium right after this. Same deal. 14th play, Hayward into the field goal. And he is true, giving Minnesota a three-point lead. Last week he was true as well. Back here, it's first down and 10. Under a minute to go in the first quarter. They set up on field goal here. The bootleg again by Chandler has a lot of room. And this tall guy can run a little bit. Oh, and that's a spin move. He got it on spin cycle and dried out the Gopher defense for another first down. Hayward, California, first down and 10. Brown split wide to the top of your screen. The three-yard line. Play fake. Chandler going to keep it himself. Touchdown, Iowa. Roney's the lone back, the two tight end formation. Hawkeyes recover the ball. Matt Ross recovered the loose ball. Third down and 10. Chandler. Davis complete for the first down at the 47-yard line. Down and 10. They run it into the boundary. Lewis has the seam. And still on his feet. Minnesota. And he fumbled it. They're going to say he didn't get in. Iowa ball. Wow.
Mark, we know the rule. If the tip of that football crosses the plane of the goal line, it's a touchdown. Right here, we're going to see Maroney. Bob Sanders punched that football out.
He's Kevin Mark in the studio breaking it down for you. Minnesota out to the 22-yard line. Maroney brought down that time by Howard Hodges.
I'm going to go on a limb. He's going to make this field goal right here. Senior day in the stadium. Wind at his back. Ball's in the middle. He's only missed one all year.
Nate Kaden from 55 yards out. They feel it. That would have been good from 65. Nate Kaden lighting up Kinnick Stadium.
Game in the Big Ten, the battle for Floyd of Rosedale, and Nate Kading late in the first half kicked a field goal from Des Moines, I think, about 55 yards out. 20-6, Iowa has the lead. What about some second half adjustments now for Minnesota?
Well, I think what Glenn Mason has to do in the second half is, I know that they're the number one rush team in the country, but as a steady diet, you can't continue to run on first down. Change it up a little bit. Couple screens, couple draws, little play action pass. Move the ball around on first down. They're too predictable running the football.
It's absolutely imperative that Iowa win this football game.
Why?
Because last week, Minnesota won an axe.
Yes.
They won the Paul Bunyan axe, and if they win the pig, what happens when you get an axe and a pig together?
I think somebody's going to get
you're going to get some bacon.
Yeah, maybe
so,
sausage.
Iowa, do it for the pig, Hawkeyes.
I'll keep the axes away from you then.
I think what happens here is that PETA is in favor of your solution here. Iowa with the lead. I think Minnesota, they'd like to have the axe and the pig. Nate Kading is putting a kick into that thing, 55 yards out for number 95. Iowa with the big lead, second half's coming.
Third down and 12 on the opening drive of the third quarter for Minnesota. Iowa showing blitz, Mark. Straight man-to-man coverage. Minnesota sees it coming. Bob Sanders on the pitch, and it's a fumble. Loose ball. And the Hawkeyes have it again. Wow, three turnovers. This one may be the most damaging because the first series of the second half is so critical. They line Bob Sanders up in the slot.
This one coming from about 34 yards out.
Lloyd. It's up a good one away from Ochoa, but he gets to it at the 35. Ramon Ochoa on the loose. On senior day, one guy to beat.
By Mr. Automatic.
Three for three today. This one coming from 38 yards out. He knocks it through. Nate Kading. A history major carrying a 3.48 GPA. Minnesota, if history serves itself well, is in trouble. They've lost the last two. A Bruce Lee's got to get it cranked up when we come back. Third and four. Picked off by Johnson. And another Minnesota turnover. O'Brien with his first catch of the day. The senior out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
He's gone through to just get healthy here.
There's Lewis. Jamel. Feeling it. Lewis. Steps out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Greatest comeback story of the year in college football. Second down and goal to go. Chandler.
Mark, that was a great catch by Ochoa. The ball thrown behind him against the Bears. Senior Bowl of Iowa City.
Razor Ochoa.
Vikings going to initiate the way to go.
Fourth and seven. Complete. First down marker catch by Hosa. And if they're spotting it where they do, it's going to be close. Now we're going to say it's incomplete. At midfield, it's first down and 10 for Nathan Chandler. Pulling the trigger for Brown. Flag down, and Brown makes the catch.
Giving himself in the play for every week.
He's going to move to 8-3 with a win here today against the Gophers. Chandler on the loose. Chandler. The big fella lowering his hat and putting it on the Gophers. First down, goal, put and goal. Cervantes, touchdown.
Senior day, Ramon Ochoa's high school teammate Cervantes gets a chance to score a touchdown in his last game at Kinnick Stadium. Mark, how about two guys coming from East LA? That is a long, long way.
Yep, a world away, Bob. But today, Iowa has been the picture of efficiency in the red zone, in stark contrast to Minnesota, who in the first half popped it up twice in the red zone. And that kind of set the tone for what was to follow. Well, the only question that still begs, who's inside that box? Got a little bacon for you. Little pork. We'll be right back. Tate. Watch him throw in practice on Thursday. He has got a rifle and cannon going on.
You're high on him. I like it. I thought you were going to start a quarterback controversy when I saw you Thursday night about how much you like Drew Tate.
I had to let him take a couple of snaps before I got that stirred up.
Yeah.
One of the most productive high school passers in Texas football history.
And ended up at Iowa because R.C. Slocum was fired at Texas A&M, was going to go to Texas A&M, but Floyd is out.
Pick for everybody.
I tell you what, the way this game has gone, Minnesota would have dropped Floyd as many times as they put that pigskin on the ground today. We got a point there, Bob Davey. A.J. Johnson.
So the Iowa Hawkeyes will have their third consecutive victory over the Minnesota Gophers in this series, competing for Floyd of Rosedale, and the goalposts are finally being lowered. The final score, 40-22, Iowa, leading to 8-3 over the season. It's been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. College Game Day Scoreboard presented by Acura is next. So long, everybody.